this tree. Massive. This is the one end of the ridge walk. Wow, that's a really big rock. Temple. Okay, so you're just always sweating here, but like somehow it's just an is. There's no way really to get away from it. I mean, air conditioning in your room so you can sleep, I think for me is kind of key. Here's one of the swing places. That's a swing. So you can swing out and get those pictures. Let's see what's up here. So now we're up. River's down there. You gotta really watch your feet. Okay, I guess this feels like as good a time as any to mention something that's really stuck with me that, and I'll post the guy's name, I'm just spacing, the Stanford professor who has a podcast. My son heard him speak at University of Oregon, and one of the things he talks about is he's talking about taking cold showers and how what the cold showers do is actually kind of provoke your nervous system into a state of stress. You know, right? Like you get all like, oh, I don't want to do this. And if we don't take ourselves to that point, and you know, this is, I'm loosely summarizing, but if we don't challenge ourselves, if we don't take ourselves to these points of, I don't know if I can do this, right? Like whether it's speaking in public or having a difficult conversation or jumping in a cold lake or walking a narrow path. If we don't do that enough, we become too used to the comfort zone. And then things that maybe wouldn't normally cause stress or that fight or flight or fear do. So I know for me, check, paragliding, right? Every time I go up to launch, it's like, checking in, managing, and the self-talk, and the practicing, and the studying, and all of that. But, so, it's just a question, as I almost trip. What could you do that would create that, oh, I don't know if I can do this, right? Like those swings. You know, of course, for a lot of people, just swinging on those swings, any kind of heights, creates that fear. But what do we know? All the tourists do that. They have you all strapped in and safe. So it's good for you to challenge yourself and to face fears. So this is funny, when I opened the Creative Fitness Center, 96, right? I had not painted really ever. And so I had painting classes, all kinds, and drawing, and like the Sculpey clay, the Millefiori clay making classes, paper mache, paper making, like we did everything. And however many years in, 8 years in, I relocated into a much smaller space that was on the main drag. And I had like basically a big walk-in closet that I built a dormer in and turned it into a studio, but I couldn't offer all the art projects. So what I did is I chose to focus just on painting classes. And the only reason I did that was because people were afraid to paint. Great business plan, right? But I noticed that my pottery students, the drawing students, the paper mache students, the paper making students, the collage students, if I mentioned the painting classes, they'd be like, oh, can't do that. But my painting students weren't afraid of anything. So when I relocated and could only basically pick one project, I decided to focus on just painting because that's what people were afraid of. And I'd opened the art center to empower people to create change that they desired in the art that is their life and to learn what they needed to do that in art class. So this is really why I teach painting. I didn't even realize, wow, okay. Honestly, when I started this, I didn't realize this is what this was coming back to, but I guess I did unconsciously because it's always been one of my greatest passions is watching people overcome fears. Hi, sorry, we're all videoing and photographing. Yeah. Say hi to the pretty people.
Hi.
And so painting is a super safe and easy way. I used to tell my students that, you know, you paint, don't worry. Like, you're not gonna solve world hunger with this painting. You're not gonna achieve financial independence. You don't have to hang it on a gallery wall. It will cause no physical pain. It will not start deducting money out of your checking account if you don't feel like it's going well or you make a mistake. Just try it. There's nothing to fear. And the coolest thing is, especially if you're afraid to paint, you will overcome fear. You will accomplish the same thing as the people that do cold plunges every day. So either, right? Okay. I think that's enough. Sending you lots of love. Bye. Okay, so coming out of the path. What threshold are you wanting to cross in fear as you maybe hesitating on the precipice? And what could you do to overcome a fear in order to overcome this fear? So say that's public speaking. You could do something like paint or cold plunge to attune yourself to overcoming fear. Because there are magical things to discover on the other side of facing fears that aren't really anything to be afraid of, right? Right. Let's just see what's up here. Well, I haven't even been here. That looks nice. The artist. Okay. Whole other world up here. I never even knew about. See how that works? Lots of painting galleries, rice fields, villas to rent, locals living here. Look at this little magical cafe, pizza and cappuccino. out. Love it. I hope you enjoyed that little walk and are getting curious about the ways that you can explore new landscapes, inner and outer. Thank you for joining me in Bali.